Hi, I'm Bruce Hunter, Associate Executive Director of AASA for Advocacy and Communications. With me is Noelle Ellerson, who has just finished the 12th in a series of snapshots that she has been taking of the economic condition of schools since the economy tanked in 2008. Noelle, what was the main thing you found this time?
It's still a little bit more of the same, thank you, Bruce. The recession continues to impact our school districts and state budgets. We were asking superintendents and school administrators to weigh in on how fiscal year 2013 is playing out at their local level. Are personnel jobs still being cut? Are there program cuts? Are you looking at altering your thermostat? Are you delaying curriculum improvements? Are you delaying construction projects? And the answer to all of those is yes. It's unfortunately still more of the same. We haven't done a full economic impact survey in more than a year, and I was really hoping that this one would be the story about refunding school and state education budgets, but that's just not the case.
What does the three-year trend look like? I think this is the first time we've ever had 3 years of economic data.
Right. This is the first survey where we asked administrators or survey respondents to report on 3 years. We asked them to indicate the types of cuts they made in 2010-11, the cuts for the 11-12 school year, and the anticipated cuts for 12-13, given that administrators are wrapping up that budget process right now. And it was the clearest trend we've seen. In the past, we've had two-year trends. But across all areas, the uptick was just so obvious. So while there were cuts in 2010-11, more people made those same types of cuts in 11-12, and even more anticipate making them in 12-13. And while that's a clearer trend, it's not new. We've always talked about how initial cuts hold on or held through the different years, and they layered on additional cuts. And this survey just reiterates the fact that school districts continue to do more with less and compounding their cuts.
Could you see the effect of ARRA and the Ed Jobs money?
Absolutely. That's a really good question. In doing some background research to complement the responses from the field, I was looking at state revenue receipts, and I was looking at overall spending and revenue in states, as well as state budget shortfalls. And it's interesting, in two of the three, state revenues are up, so they're collecting more tax receipts in the final months of fiscal year 2011 than they did in 2010 or 2009. But that's still below pre-recession levels, but it is the first time we've seen an uptick in state receipts. General state budgets are up in overall, but when you look at spending trends, states are still reporting massive shortfalls. So when you look at funding cuts over the last 4 years at the state level, it's over $540 billion in shortfalls at the state level. And ARRA and EduJobs contribute to that. When you look at FY9, FY10, and FY11, those cuts are attributed to the recession itself, and the continued shortfalls at FY12 and FY13 are the cessation of ARRA and EduJobs. And I think it speaks to the fact that, as we anticipated and reported, states were supplanting with some of those dollars, which were supposed to be supplementary.
Well, when ARRA and EduJobs happened, we talked about an eventual funding cliff, particularly if the states used the money in areas outside of education, because all of those dollars were supposed to go to education. Is that what happened?
That is in large part what we think happened. I mean, this is the last year where school districts, if they have ARRA in their budgets, it's because they had a waiver to extend their timeline. So this is the last school year where they will have their ARRA dollars, and this is the last school year where they will have their EduJobs dollars. Looking at the spend out of EduJobs, I was intrigued to see that it was pretty evenly split between the number of respondents who indicated that they spent all of their EduJobs in 10-11, or all of it in 11-12, or spread it out over the two. But either way, all of EduJobs will be expended by the end of this school year as well, and that double funding cliff is looming large.
So how many people are likely to be laid off this next year, according to our data?
Well, when we look at, we had 528 responses from 48 states, and the average personnel in those schools was about 590, I believe. And over 3 years, they've eliminated about 30 positions. So it's about 10 per year, about a 2% elimination rate per year. And when you have school districts that widely consistently eliminating positions, you know it's a hard time, because that's one of the last things they want to cut are teacher jobs. And they're bracing for even more. We have to talk about sequestration and policy priorities for Congress.
If Congress does the deep cut in sequestration, there will be another round of layoffs in 2013.
We widely anticipate that. If Congress is unable to put together that tax plan, we'll be looking at a 9.1% across the board cut, which is unprecedented. That'd be $4.1 billion to the Department of Ed, which would be huge with its implications for Title I and IDEA.
So even though the economy is coming back, states are still not spending the money in education the way they should, and the federal government is reducing its expenditures the way they should.
And that federal, even though the federal economy has recovered, sequestration could very much undermine the stability that is starting to take hold at the state and local level.
Stay tuned.
Thank you.